Praxis Prepper.
Hey everybody, this is Praxis, and in this video we're talking about the Seiko 5 auto-wind watch. It's the kind of watch with a little pendulum inside, so as you're, you know, just kind of walking around, it's self-winding. Overall, I've been very pleased with it, and specifically in this video, I want to talk about its water resistance functions. Now, this watch said that it was water resistant to 30 meters. Now, when I was purchasing it, you know, I'm not like a watch aficionado. I'll admit to that freely right at the moment, but 30 meters to me when I was buying it sounded like it was good to 30 meters below water, which, you know, I'm not a scuba diver, so I was like, well, that'll be fine for me. But once I opened up the packaging, water resistant to 30 meters kind of gets defined and delineated inside the actual literature that comes with the watch, and the way that Seiko kind of presents it is that water resistant to 30 meters means that you can be out in rain with it, you know, you could maybe take a shower with it. You could do a little bit of swimming, but not a lot of swimming. I don't know what the difference is between a little and a lot. It was just sort of ambiguous, and water resistant to 30 meters was not described in any way, shape, or form like what I was thinking, that it could go 30 meters below water and it would be fine. So what I've been doing is, you know, I don't want to be hamstrung with some watch that I have to take off all the time and, you know, every time I'm going to get wet or whatever. So I've just been kind of using it, and I want to share with you kind of what my experiences have been with it so far. I haven't been doing a lot of swimming with it, but what I have been doing is a lot of just moving around in the water, like putting my hands in the water. I've been building a wall here by this little stream to kind of direct the current. I've been picking up a lot of rocks in there, and I've been sticking my hand in all the way down to, like, you know, my elbows and past, which is, you know, a couple of feet. And so far, the watch has not had any ill effects from that. I've seen some other tests on YouTube where people took the watch and they put in a little glass of water where it's just a couple inches under the water and it's not moving around or anything like that. But I've actually been taking it, I've actually been using it, sticking my hands under there, it's been in mud and everything, and it's still ticking. I've been doing that for several days now. I've been looking into the back of it to see if I can see any kind of water getting in, any condensation or anything like that, and I haven't seen any evidence of that. Now, there are other watches that are good to 50 meters or 100 meters, and I guess 50 or 100 meters, as I've been doing research later, those are sort of like the entry-level sort of things if you really want to do a lot of swimming with it. But for this watch, for the 30 meter resistance that this offers, I found that just any general stuff that you're doing that isn't you actually diving down below the surface of the water, because I haven't tested that, maybe that is also fine, but I haven't tested it personally, but any kind of just general day-to-day stuff, reaching your hands in water and everything like that, that's all fine with this watch. So I've been pretty pleased with this watch. Overall, it's a nice clean look. I've actually scratched up the glass, but I only did that when I was moving giant boulders, and I was grabbing the boulders and some grit got on and it really gouged up the glass, and I kind of kicked myself because it was really nice looking prior to that, and I kind of scraped it up, but I took some glue that people use for jewelry making, clear glue that'll stick to glass, and I got the thing all really cleaned out and I put the glue in there, and that kind of diminished the look of the scuff so that at least it's not getting garbage down in there or anything. But anyway, if you're interested in the Seiko 5 watch and you want something that's going to be somewhat water resistant, just for general everyday stuff if you're an outdoors person, not necessarily going diving, but, you know, getting your hands wet, getting your, you know, arms in the water, this watch has worked out really fine for me. I hope that you find that helpful if you're kind of on the fence about this watch, because it's a very inexpensive watch compared to a lot of other, you know, waterproof watches that are, you know, with this 50 and 100 meter level. This one here is under $70 when I purchased it, and I found that it's a pretty good value. So I hope you find that helpful. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and tune in every Friday at 4:30 New York time for a new video. And if you'd like to support this channel, you can do so both through Patreon or PayPal.